Oh, it's Thanksgiving. What am I gonna do? Got a choice, really. Go out to clubs and have loads of sex with loads of women, because, you know, obviously. Or play my PlayStation Vita, which has PlayStation 4 remote play. Vita it is.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way, so I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And
ladies and gents, this is Michael Burhan again for another vloggy thing. Today we're doing it Thursday instead of Friday, and the reason being is I have a comics rundown which is really ambitious, so yeah. But this is the vloggy thing, and as always we're going to try and cram some news into 5 minutes or less. Kind of like herpes. I didn't think that one through. That's what she said. Just been announced that Marvel and Fox are basically doing some untitled movies in 2018. It's been signaled for November 2nd, 2018, I believe. One of these movies is going to be Deadpool, as it's found its new director, so we're going to be seeing that hitting the cinemas for Deadpool 2. Yay! The other one is going to be an untitled X-Men movie, so we don't actually know what that's going to be just yet. But we've also got a James Cameron movie that's been announced, but that's been untitled because they don't know what it is. I think it's another Avatar movie, which is great. You're going to see more people sticking the things that they used to compilate in animals. Man, these things are sick. In other news, Capcom recently decided to turn the whole Dead Rising co-op multiplayer thing on its head and decided, yeah, we're not going to give you in-game co-op because we're arseholes. We're instead going to give you standalone online multiplayer features for some reason. So what it means is if you're basically playing the game on the Xbox One or PC, as it's going to be released around about Christmas this year, I believe, then you'll get the chance to play loads of little co-op games if you want to play with your friends. Other than that, you have to play the story mode on your own. I know I'm one of those people that like to have a little bit of story play with my friends because I have a little help with my friends. But for anybody else that doesn't really want that, you get this online co-op thing, which I really don't give a crap about, so. So, let's talk about Standing Rock. Thing is, this doesn't actually get covered by a lot of international media. I have no idea why. You've had Philip Franco cover it on his channel, so if you want to go and check the link on that. John Oliver has covered it. Nearly any person who's not a major news outlet here in the United Kingdom hasn't covered this. Thinking about Thanksgiving, how most people give thanks, that a lot of Americans came out of oppression from the United Kingdom. Sorry, my ancestors did that to you. But the thing that's no joke here is the fact that you've got a bunch of people who are protesting because they want their land. This is pretty much what this story is. They want this land. It's a sacred burial site. And you've got a big corporation coming in, putting a pipeline in there, disrupting the land. And they are violating all kinds of freaking rights here. There was a treaty that was signed stating that this is their land. The government has no right to this land. Corporations have no right to this land. So it's technically they're trespassing on Native American property here, which is all kinds of freaking wrong. And secondly, they've got this huge issue with the First Amendment right to peaceful protest that you have here, which is placed in the American Constitution. And I know I'm not one who should be talking about the American Constitution because I'm English. And I'm also brown with a beard. Take that as you will. But the thing is that you've got to think about this whole situation is, well, people are having their rights violated and no one seems to have a problem with this. You have armed police shooting rubber bullets at these guys. People turning a hose on these people in freaking freezing weather. What the hell is going on? Have people lost their sanity all of a sudden? Yes, I understand Trump has been elected president of the United States. And a lot of people from the left are sitting there going, oh my God, this is happening. But that's not the insane thing. This is the Trump being elected is actually more sane than this. And if you think about it, if you think about what these people are going through, this isn't right. These are men, these are women, these are children who are trying to preserve their land, who are having their rights violated, which is against the Constitution, it's against the freaking law, it's against all other moral freaking rights, if you basically have any sort of moral compass, and nobody seems to think that this is wrong apart from, well, it has been reported by a lot of American media as well, including right-wing stations such as Fox, so kudos to Fox, they have been the kind of the voice of reason in a sense. But in a sense, I don't think the politicians involved in this and the people who are taking away these people's land should be doing this. It boggles the mind, you know, how an English person talking to you in front of a camera is trying to give you the aspects of morality here, because it's ambiguous morality at best. It's basically the same thing you would penalize someone for if they were arrested for stealing or if they were arrested for harming another human being. How can you sit back and tell your kids, hey Jimmy, it's okay for the government to steal from you and it's okay for big corporations to steal from you, but it's not okay for you to steal to feed your family because you're gonna go to prison and you'll probably end up making shirts for someone. If you can help, please do. I've sent the links at the bottom for donations if you need to, like, you know, help these people out. Spread the word. Make sure you get the news out there. So if you want to give thanks, make sure that you give thanks for the right things in life, for the things that you've done, for the men and women out there who fight for our civil liberties every single day. So we have the right for free speech to actually go in front of cameras and talk to you lovely people. If you're an American who believes in the rights and the freedoms that the Constitution gives you, make sure that you support with the people at Standing Rock because they are in their constitutional right to be there. So there you go. So yeah, that's pretty much it from me, guys, and I am completely and utterly just, I don't know, I'm drained today. I've been reporting on so many sad aspects of the news, and 2016 really needs to just die. I think we need someone to go and find 2016, put a bullet in its head, and just watch it bleed to death like a weird Tarantino movie, because honestly, I am sick and tired of this year. I think everybody is sick and tired of this year. We have loved, we have lost, and we've lost a huge load of celebrities past our time. It's just like we're going through a cleansing of some sorts. But yeah, that's it from me. I shall see you again another week for another vloggy. And what I'm going to do is go through creepy baby names just for you. And I'm going to do it in a creepy voice.
Hello. Is your name Melissa? Yeah, Jeffrey. That's a great name. What about Theo? Theo's a very common baby name.
That's it from me, guys. Don't have nightmares. And just remember, if there's something creeping under the sheets, it's probably me. Sorry. I get like that sometimes.